Hey there, Pan friends. Welcome to the channel again. It's your host, Amy from Pan Venture, and this is another Fun Pan collection update video. In this video, we are going to discuss some of the movements in my personal Fun Pan collection. And those are some big movements, really big. Grail pens, that's an understatement. Sit around and let's see what we have. I would have to say that this is the kind of video that I will probably see years from now and still have goosebumps only watching it, because it's going to be sprinkled with some of the most interesting emotions and fountain pens that I currently own in my personal collection. And I kid you not, you will see. The first subject that I want to address is that there is no fountain pens that are going to leave the collection. So that's a bonus, a good thing. No. I'm completely missing the point, because it's one of the biggest and the most interesting fountain pens in my collection that will leave the collection. But stick with me till the end of the video and you will find out why it's not such a tragedy. First of all, let's start with something that's just recently landed in my personal collection. And that is the Visconti Corsani Octagonal. And this is the second edition from Corsani. And it's beautiful in green stacked celluloid. Beautiful fountain pen. And I've made a video with the unboxing for this fountain pen. I'm gonna try to link the video up here, or up here, I don't know where, but you will find the video. Since then, I've put some ink in it, I've used it, and it is a joy to use this fountain pen. I like it a lot. I like what Stefano is putting up as its exclusive editions, gorgeous examples of fine writing instruments. I will dive into more details about this fountain pen once I will be ready to record a video review, because there are some other pens that need to be showcased with a full story in this video. We are going to add this fountain pen to the list down below. You'll find the updated list of my personal fountain pen collection. The second pen that recently arrived is none other than my Onoto Spitfire number 89 of 100. Yes, just like I told you, I'm gonna go out and buy this fountain pen for my personal collection. I wanna thank the guys at Onoto for being so kind and generous with me, allowing me to pick a number, a certain number, number 89 of 100. They sent me a Spitfire for review on loan, and I've returned that fountain pen back at the factory. I've decided to go further and purchase this fountain pen in a tiny bit different configuration. We have a fine nib, 18 karat, beautiful, beautiful size 7F nib. And now, different from the fountain pen that I've reviewed, and talking about that, I'm gonna link the video someplace up here in the corners with the video review of the Spitfire. This time on my fountain pen, I went with a plunge filling system. It adds a little bit of weight, and I simply love this filling system. This fountain pen is actually made from aluminum, from an actual Spitfire plane that flew over the skies of London and defended London in the Battle of Britain in World War II. So this is a fountain pen that, I don't know how to say this, but you actually write with a piece of history, functional history. If you want to watch the video review, you probably clicked already in the corner, and you can get to see more of the details of this fountain pen. Let's welcome this fountain pen in my collection and update the list down below. And let's move on to the final contender of the series that it will leave the collection. And this is, I don't know how to say this, and I don't want to be understood wrong, but I have never thought I'm gonna end up passing this fountain pen to another owner. Actually, if I had to use the word selling, it's not weighing as much as I want. For this fountain pen, I've chose to say that I'm gonna pass the ownership to a very, very kind and good person that I think is going to be the greatest custodian for this fountain pen. The story of this pen is quite interesting. The first time that I've entered in this hobby, I was fascinated by the Classic Pens LB5. And actually, if you can check my Instagram page, the Pen Venture Instagram page, you can scroll down to the very first picture from that profile, and you will find out that the picture is a full display of every single color of the Classic Pens LB5 series. Fascinating pens. And I've entered and speak with Andreas Lembrou from Classic Pens, but I had no luck. I couldn't find any of those pens available. And I was that newbie. And I've contacted Stephen Brown and asked if he was willing to sell his Classic Pens, the red one. Now I can really grasp how much a pen like that can mean to a person, because I've ended up acquiring it a few years ago. I was very, very happy because I fulfilled a dream to actually get that pen. And I have it right here. So this pen is the Classic Pens LB5, made in collaboration project by Classic Pens with Sailor. It's also called the King Prophet. It's based on the King of Pens. It's big, it's a little bit bigger than the base model. It comes in a variety of colors. It's made in diffusion bonded acrylic. And this is the purple model, and it's called the Tairiku. And I hope I'm not butchering that word. And this is a pen that I've strived myself to keep pristine. I've been using it ever since, but very, very gently. And I was fascinated by this pen. I've took this pen with me in a lot of my travels in Italy, and I've handed over this pen for my good friends in Italy to test, and they were all shocked by how good this nib writes. And this is a pen that I've developed stories together with it, and I've enjoyed it a lot. Recently, it stayed unused for a couple of months, and I begin to think that I could say that I want to pass it over to someone else. I have to say that I've got questions about this fountain pen, if I'm going to sell it, at least once or two times per month ever since I've owned this pen. So this is one of the reasons that I didn't want to showcase it on my Instagram page too much, because I didn't want it to have many questions if I'm ever going to sell it. But against all odds, there is a person that I've chatted quite a lot of times about this pen, and that person is my good friend Kim from Holland. I've promised him that if I ever going to think about selling this pen, he will be the first person to know about it. There were some events that made me to go further and decide that I want to pass the ownership of this fountain pen, and probably it will make a lot of sense if you guys are watching my channel and you will see the further videos from this one. My mind clicked, so I wanted to pass the ownership of this fountain pen, so I've sent him a message and told him, hey, Kim, I think it's time to actually think about selling the Classic Pens. Unfortunately, he and I could not make a deal. He wasn't ready to actually go further with the purchase of this fountain pen. And I admire his friendship because he is such a good person that he told me, Emmy, I have one person in mind. Give me a day or two. Don't post anywhere about this fountain pen. Let me speak with him. And if it's not me, then I'm going to get that pen. I want to help you and find you a good owner for that pen. That is why I simply love to be part of this community, because I can say that I have some friends that are wonderful people. It's simply amazing. He got in contact with that person, and that person wanted to know a little bit more about this pen, and we settled on a few facts. And since this is such an important pen, the value for this fountain pen, I'm not going to disclose, neither the person that is the new owner of this pen. And I'm just going to try if you're watching this video, the lucky new owner, let me tell you that I'm happy. I've settled, moved on to another pen, which you will probably see in the next videos. And I'm happy for you. I can't wait to meet you, like we agreed. I think you are the right person for this fountain pen. I have here the box. It's mint, pristine condition, classic pens box with all of the documents and everything. So this pen, it's minutes away from being bubble wrapped, put in a box and heading over to you. Please take care of it, enjoy it, use it, cherish it. And above everything, with this pen, you actually gained a friend, myself. And I think this is one of the best things about saying goodbye to this fountain pen. I'm gonna miss it, yes. But I think I'm gonna enjoy more the pen that's going to come next after this. That is probably what I had to say in this video. And I hope you guys can really grasp and understand the process behind my collection. And I use my collection to interact with people. So my collection has a purpose. It has the purpose to connect me with my audience. That means that you guys that are watching me are going to have a certain item that we can both relay on and connect. I've enjoyed this fountain pen for a lot of years. And now I think it's time to say goodbye and see it in someone else's collection and making another person happy. I am happy at this moment, letting it go. So it's time to say farewell. This is how I want to end the video. I'm gonna stop here because if I would have to continue from here, I'm gonna spoil the surprise for the next video. I'm gonna update the list down below with all of the pens that enter the collection and the ones that are going to leave the collection. If you want to find out more about that, you can check the list down below and you can see the updated list of my entire collection. And I really hope that you guys can enjoy videos like this, because for me it's emotional. It has to be showcased because it's not just a simple pen. It's a pen that I've enjoyed owning. It's a pen that I've enjoyed collecting, having, writing with it. I was and still am proud of taking this pen anywhere with me and showing a person that this is a fountain pen that's one of the most rarest pens in existence, which I think a lot of you can debate with me upon that. But at least for myself, it's one of the most desired fountain pens in my collection. Farewell, and let's see. If you're not subscribed yet to the Pen Venture YouTube channel, you can do that by clicking here. And you can turn the notification bell on. And if you want to see more quality content from Pen Venture and myself, you can click on this video, watch it, and enjoy. My name is Emmy, and I look forward to seeing you next video. Take care, stay safe, bye-bye.